Yes, Erin, show us.
6 o'clock.
Really? How? Right, you're going to show me how? Come up here.
Go around.
Come on, come around so you can point to it and show us.
Because the big one ain't no minutes, and the little one, there's only
What do you
six.
Mean there's no minutes? What does that mean?
Seconds.
This is the long hand, right? So that's our minute hand, and this is our hour hand. So let's start with the hour, and the hour is pointed at what?
The hour hand is pointing at 6.
Okay, so I will put 6 on there.
You got to switch it completely, so
right.
We got to make it go to 12:15. So the digital clock, that's okay. So yes, here, it says 6 o'clock, right? What does the digital clock say?
This is the digital clock.
12:15.
Right.
Ah.
So can we make this, so you got the harder problem. We need to make this match what that says. So what would I move? If this is our hour hand and this is our minute hand, and I needed to say 12:15, where does the hour hand need to go?
The hour hand is 6 o'clock.
It's on 6, yes, right now. But where does it need to go so that it matches what the digital time says?
Need to go
on the 6. Well, the 6 would be 6 o'clock then, yes? So if this is the hour hand, where do I need this hand to move to so that it matches this number?
How would you show 12, Yasir?
Yeah.
So how do you make it 12 o'clock, Yasir?
Little hand on the 12.
Thank you. Does that match 12 o'clock and 12:15?
Yes.
It matches? 12 o'clock and 12:15? What do we need to change? Well, we want to show this one to say the same time as this. So we did the hour hand, and we moved it to the 12. Where do we move the minute hand so that it shows 15 minutes?
On the 3.
On the 3. Can you tell us why?
Because I counted my
10s
in my head.
By
10s
or by? 5. By 5s.
Nice job, Miss Sarah.
Yes.
I want everybody to notice something. Did Yasir know the answer right away?
No.
Does that mean that he gave up?
No.
Listen, math is a struggle. Math is about trying to solve a problem. Nobody said it's easy. Nobody says you're going to know the answer right away. If you knew the answer right away, you'd be a genius. Math is about figuring it out. I really like how Ms. Ruiz asked the right questions, and Yasir finally figured out where he wanted to go with the answer. So good job. It's awesome. He's asking why it's not exactly on the 12.
Oh, that it moved?
Oh. Do you know why it moved, Jessier?
Do you know why? It's okay.
That's a good question.
You can try.
Do you know why it moved, Lucas?
Oh, no. Because the minute.
Yeah. So, Mr. Weiss, show them what happens. I want you guys to watch the minute hand and the hour hand at the same time.
Up or down?
Just go around to and take the minute hand. Yeah. Look what's happening to the hour hand. What's it slowly doing? What's it slowly moving towards? Where is it moving towards?
The one.
Do you know why?
Because the minute hand is moving.
They don't work separately. They work together. So yes, that was a great point. Ms. Ruiz, put it back on the 12 o'clock. Watch what happens, Yasir. Watch what happens to it now. Now, Mr. Ruiz is going to move the minute hand to the 15, and watch what happens to the hour hand. Do you see how it's moving at the same time, buddy?
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, that's because you've already spent 15 of the minutes in that hour.
And if you move the hour hand, the minute hand will move
they do work together. Both of them work together, yes.
So the second hand makes the minute hand move, and the minute hand makes the hour hand move. They're all connected.
Mm-hmm.
And if you watch, Yesir, do you know what hand is moving on this clock right now? What hand is moving?
The second hand.
And what hand does that make move? The second
minute
hand makes the, yeah, and then the minute hand makes the?
Which one move?
Keep thinking, kid.
Yes. All of our clocks move in this direction. On our clock that we have in the middle, we have arrows that show us which direction the clock moves in, the hands on the clock move in. That is called clockwise. Okay? When it's going around in that direction, it's called clockwise. So it shows us which direction the hands are supposed to move on our clock. That's a very good point.
Yeah.
To let it into the next thing.
When you guys ask questions, it really helps your brain understand the information.
Mm-hmm.
Can we go home?
Oh, you know what? No. But you know what? ABCA has a lot of time games on there. ABCA.
Great job.
Starfall, even though.
Yeah.
How do you spell it?
You got it correct. Okay, so now we want to match our analog clock with the time that is displayed on our digital clock. Put the hour hand on the 3, okay? And the minute hand on the 3. Did we see what happened to the hour hand again? When I moved it to 3. Nehemiah, did you see that?
Mm-hmm.
You did? Mm-hmm. I'm going to move it back to where it was.
Nehemiah, watch. Watch the screen, babe.
Okay. He said to move the hour hand to the 3. So it's on the 3. Almost. There we go. And then I'm moving the minute hand to the 3 for 15 minutes. Did the hour hand move, Nehemiah? Or did it stay where it was? It did? I don't know if you're looking.
On the three.
The hour hand on the 3, and it is 3 o'clock. But I'm going to move it to the 3 for 15 minutes. Did the hour hand move? It moved.
Good job,
Lucas. Woo,
woo! Awesomeness.
Can I hold on. What's that?
Can I
put
my
hand on
the
clock?
Yes.
Okay. Okay.
Can I
Again, we are changing the analog clock to match our digital time. Where should we move it? Where should we move the hour hand? How about our minutes? Nehemiah, I need you to watch, okay? To the 7. To the 7. And how about the minute hand? The 11. Can you count out and show us why?
5, 10, 15, 20, 25, 30, 35, 50, 55.
Hold on, hold
35,
on. Go back to 30.
30.
30,
35, 40, 45, 50,
50.
Thank you.
Good job.
Good job.
Our
hand did move.
It did move. It's almost touching the 8. Why is it almost touching the 8, guys?
Because of the bit of hand is moving.
Yeah, but be more specific. How many minutes of the seventh hour have we used?
I don't know.